सबको नमस्कार लेट गा स्टार्ट చేస్తున్నాను సారీ అనివాల వర్షం మానుకుని మమ్మల్ని ఈ సమయం కేటాయించి ఇచ్చినందుకు వెల్కమ్ ముందుగా నాట్స్ మార్కెట్ వర్గం తరపున మనకి డాలస్ లో మొట్టమొదటిసారిగా వాస్తు గురించి సెమినార్ ఆర్గనైజ్ చేసి మనందరికీ వాస్తు ఎక్స్పర్ట్ నుండి డీటెయిల్స్ అందజేస్తున్న నాట్స్ వాడికి కృతజ్ఞతలు మీ అందరికీ వెల్కమ్ అండ్ స్పెషల్ గా మన స్పెషల్ గెస్ట్ ఫ్యాంటో నిరంజన్ బాబు గారికి స్పెషల్ వెల్కమ్ ఇవాళ మన కార్యక్రమంలోకి వెళ్ళకముందల నాట్స్ గురించి ఒక రెండు పదాలు చెప్తాను అండ్ నాట్స్ వాళ్ళు ఆర్గనైజ్ చేసే కొన్ని ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ అప్కమింగ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ కొంచెం క్విక్ గా డీటెయిల్స్ ఇచ్చి మన ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ వెళ్తాం ఉత్తర ఆంధ్ర ఉత్తర అమెరికా తెలుగు సంఘం నార్త్ అమెరికా తెలుగు అసోసియేషన్ నాట్స్ గురించి మీ అందరికి చాలా మటుకు తెలిసింది అనుకుంటాను నేను ఈ మధ్యకాలం జాయిన్ అయ్యాను నాకు వాళ్ళ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్స్ ఐడియాస్ చాలా నచ్చినాయి పెద్ద చిన్న లేకుండా ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ అనేది చూడకుండా ఎవరికి చేరు తీసుకుంటారు సొంత టైంలో ఎవరికి తోచినంత వాలంటీర్షిప్ చేస్తున్నారు సో మీ అందరు కూడా మీకు తోచినంత సమయం కానీ ఆర్థిక సహాయం చేస్తే నాట్స్ వాళ్ళు మరిన్ని కార్యక్రమాలు మీ ముందుకు తీసుకొస్తారు మొదటిగా ఇప్పుడు థ్యాంక్స్ గివింగ్ వీకెండ్ వచ్చి ప్రోగ్రామ్ గురించి కొంచెం డీటెయిల్స్ ఇస్తాను నా నెహ్రూ గారి బర్త్డే సెలబ్రేషన్ సందర్భంగా పాలల సంబరాలు అనే ఒక ప్రోగ్రామ్ జరగబోతుంది ఇది మన లూయిస్విల్ గ్రాండ్ ఆర్ట్స్ థియేటర్లో నవంబర్ 24 వన్ ఓ క్లాక్ అండ్ 7 o'clock వరకు అండి కాంపిటీషన్స్ చాలా క్యాటగిరీస్లో ఉన్నాయి మ్యూజిక్ డ్యాన్స్ ఎస్సే రైటింగ్ తెలుగు స్పెషల్ తెలుగు బేస్డ్ ఎలక్షన్ ఎలక్యూషన్ ఎస్సే రైటింగ్స్ ప్లస్ ఫస్ట్ టైం చెస్ కాంపిటీషన్ కూడా అరేంజ్ చేశాము చెస్ కాంపిటీషన్ ఈసారి స్పెసిఫిక్గా యుఎస్సిఎఫ్ అనే ఆర్గనైజేషన్ వాళ్ళు కండక్ట్ చేస్తున్నారండి సో చాలా సీరియస్గానే చేస్తున్నాము మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ కానీ మీ పిల్లలు కానీ మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ పిల్లలు ఎవరికి ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఉందో డెఫినెట్గా ఇంప్రూవ్ అవ్వండి అట్లానే మన ట్రెడిషనల్ సింగింగ్ డ్యాన్సింగ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ కూడా చాలా ఉన్నాయి మీ ప్రోత్సాహంతో ఈ ప్రోగ్రామ్ని సక్సెస్ చేస్తామని కోరుకుంటున్నాము రెండోది వచ్చే సంవత్సరం జరగబోతున్న ఘనంగా జరగబోతున్న మన నాట్స్ అమెరికా తెలుగు సంబరాలకి ఆల్రెడీ సన్నాహాలు మొదలయ్యాయి మీరందరూ కూడా అందరూ విచ్ చేసి మీ సమయం కేటాయించి నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్ విచ్ చేసి దాన్ని జయప్రదం చేయవలసిందిగా కోరుకుంటున్నాము ఇందులో ఆల్రెడీ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ గెస్టులు కన్ఫర్మ్ అయ్యారు మీకు తెలిసిందే గణపతి సచ్చిదానంద స్వామిజీ గారు ప్రోగ్రామ్ స్టార్ట్ చేస్తారు ఇది జులై 4, 4 నుండి 6 రోజులు అరవింద్ కన్వెన్షన్ సెంటర్లో జరుగుతుంది సో మళ్ళీ అందరూ స్కెడ్యూల్స్ బ్లాక్ చేసుకుని వస్తారని ఆశిస్తున్నాము మనకి మ్యూజిక్ డైరెక్టర్ కూడా కీరవాణి గారు కన్ఫర్మ్ అయ్యారు లుకింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ టు ఇట్ సో ఈ రెండు ఇప్పుడు వరకు కన్ఫర్మ్ అయిన ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ అన్ని నాట్స్ నుండి మీ అందరికీ ఏమైనా ఐడియాస్ ఉన్నా మీ మీ టైం కేటాయించగలిగిన డొనేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్వేస్ వెల్కమ్ ఇట్లా ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ చేయడానికి చాలా ఆర్థిక సహాయం కావాలి సో మీరు ఏ తోచినంత ఏ సహాయం చేసినా చాలా హెల్ప్ చేస్తారు సో దీంతో నేను శ్రీష బాగిరెడ్డి గారిని మన బ్యాంగ్లూర్ నిరంజన్ బాబు గురించి ప్లస్ ఒక ప్రోగ్రామ్ గురించి చెప్పడానికి ఆనందిస్తాను
So we'll be doing this program in English and the question and answers can be in English and Telugu. We have a wonderful program set, I mean, prepared for you. Firstly, we have Vastu and after that we have question and answers. Before question and answers, we have a break where some bathroom snacks. Vastu Shastram is basically around 10,000 years old. And it's not like something, it's not a belief based system. It's based on arrangements and balancing of 5 elements in their proper order and proportions. Vastu Shastram is to live in harmony with our environment so that the energy surrounding us works for us rather than against us. I want to introduce to you today Bangalore Niranjan Babu Garu, who has a degree both science and commerce and postgraduate education in journalism. He is actively associated with the astrological magazine of Dr. B.B. Raman for over 23 years and he took care of several responsibilities as CEO and publisher of the magazine editor. This is basically the magazine that Dr. P.P. Raman garu has started like in almost 33 years ago. So he has a, this is a actually a magazine which is published in India, and it's a regular magazine that people buy. He was chairman of Raman and Rajeshwari Research Foundation in 2010. Now he's a chief editor of the astrological e-magazine, which is launched in June 2009. Bangalore Niranjan Babu garu is a well-known international consultant for individuals, businesses and industries in Vastu, the author of international bestseller Handbook of Vastu, Vastu Relevance to Modern Times and Vastu, Directional Influences on Human Affairs. This is the book that he has scripted, and it's up on sale. Also, he is also a Vastu consultant for well-known temples, complexes and religious institutions. He's a Vastu specialist for Sri Dharmasthala Manjunathishwara Dharmodhana Trust, Dharmasthala India, which is maintained and managed by a large number of spiritually popular, well-known and well-established ageless temples. Niranjan Babu garu and his wife Uma Rani garu visited many places in US in 2011 and advised several existing and upcoming temple projects that includes ISKCON California, Karisiti Hanuman Temple, Dallas, Sri Shirdi Sai Baba Temple, Plano, and several other temples in the US. He organized various seminars on astrology and Vastu along with scholars and researchers, which are attended by more than 300 astrological students and teachers. Niranjan Babu garu was honored with the title Dattapitam Asthana Vidhana by Avadhuta Dattapitam Jagadguru Parampuji Sri Ganita Sachidananda Swamiji. He was specially invited for giving various lectures, workshops and seminars in India, USA and UK and Russia, in addition to several projects initiated there. He was the principal speaker on Vastu at 5th International Symposium on Vedic Astrology held at San Diego, USA in 1997, and also attended 6th International Symposium on Vedic Astrology at Arizona. He wrote several popular Vastu books like Vastu Directional Influences on Human Affairs. In addition, he wrote many books in Kannada and Malayalam languages too. He's initiated several Vastu courses like Vastu Shastra in Bangalore. His interest in also includes yoga, acupuncture, Ayurveda, homeopathy, Vedic astrology, Hindu trilogy and Hindu philosophy, computers and photography. Without much delay, I want to welcome Sri Bangalore Niranjan Babu garu to the stage, and I request Mr. R.K. Patti garu to come and please give him a book. R.K. Patti garu, please come.
Shirisha has already spoken much about me, but let me make a small introduction of myself again. నా పేరు నిరంజన్ బాబు అని, మా నాన్నగారి పేరు డాక్టర్ బివి రామన్ అని. ఆయన జ్యోతిష శిఖరంగా హీవాజ్ అట్ ద టాప్ అండ్ he restarted this magazine in 1936, which was originally started by my father's grandfather, that is my great grandfather, in 1895. So 1895 la shuru aina magazine ni ippudu nenu continue chestunnanu. It is not just available as a print copy, it is also available as a soft copy, and it's available also for your handheld gadgets like your iPhones and iPads and such other things. నేను మాట్లాడేది మీకు వినపడుతుందా? So what I was trying to say is, the man saying, you know, dates back to 1895, and our interest has always been to propagate ancient sciences, including astrology, vastu, yoga, which was my mother's subject for over 5 decades, and in other aspects of Indian culture, it would be the general philosophy, Vedanta, meditation, mantra shastra, whatever it is. So this man saying is aiming to do all that. This apart, like Shirisha said, I've written quite a few books on different aspects of vastu as relevant to different areas of the world. See, basically people are not aware what exactly vastu shastra is. Many people think, most of the people in fact, they think that Vastu Shastra means breaking up walls. For instance, I had indicated to one person that, you know, I would like to present a few floor plans and then discuss on that. But I got a reply saying that, what's the use of discussing floor plans when nothing can be broken? So I said, so what I say is, my interest is not to break anything. My interest is to analyze, tell you what are the plus points for a family, what are the minus points for a business, and such other things. For instance, you can't hear?
No.
What's the problem here?
Like this way.
The problem is, you know, I never held a speaker like this. I only stand and speak, you know, so. So what I'm trying to say is, Vastu Shastra basically deals with the primary elements. We speak of different mandalas. One mandala, which is called Pita Mandala, that identifies the primary elements. So the importance of the primary elements are given by identifying them in certain areas of a quadrangle, which we call as the mandala. So when we give importance to the Panchabhuta, it only means that the first option is to go with nature and not against nature. ఇప్పుడు ఎందుకు అది చెప్తానంటే, పీపుల్ కమ్ టు మీ, దే టెల్ మీ సార్, నార్త్ ఈస్ట్ లో టెంకాయ చెట్టు ఉంది, మా కన్సల్టెంట్ మా అడ్వైజర్ మా బెస్ట్ ఫ్రెండ్ అని చెప్పే కొట్టుకోయాలని పలు బాగా ఇస్తుంది, నాకు ఇన్నాళ్ళు ఏమి కాలేదు, ఏం ప్రాబ్లం కాలేదు, ఇప్పుడు అది వాస్తు ప్రకారం తప్పు ఇవ్వండి అని చెప్తున్నారు. అదే నేనేం చెప్తా అంటే, యూ డోంట్ నీడ్ టు రిమూవ్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఫర్ ద సింపుల్ రీజన్ దట్ ఈస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ నేచర్. Whether it's in Ishanya, whether it's in the southwest, whether whichever part, that is nature's, you don't need to remove. So anke mere intlo endro janalu anukuntunte idu perugutundi adu perugutundi, let me remove all that, and you don't need to do that. That's what I want to say first. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Maybe without the speaker only, I'll try to, you know, So now coming to this aspect, when I'm still in the Panchabhutas, coming to this Panchabhutas, what I would suggest is, whenever you know you plan to build a home in your particular site, the first importance should be given to plants. So plants, generally what I would say is,
can't hear please.
Are you still not hearing?
No.
Yeah.
I'll give you a small
suggestion. First of all, mobiles are off chest pettukondi. Edu nenemo cheptunnaru venakku potanu appudu na voice telusaledo aa madhyalo mee mobile sound vaste nenu cheppindanni zero aipothundi. So I would suggest you first put your phones to silent mode. So what I was trying to say is,
I am trying to, you know, particularly talk with reference to the American home. అమెరికా సంస్థ నేను ప్రాంత పై చూస్తుండే ప్రకారం ఏం అబ్జర్వేషన్ అవుతుంది అంటే ఈ వాట్ వి కాల్ ద లేఅవుట్స్ యూనో యూత్ పీపుల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ కాల్ ఇట్ కమ్యూనిటీ పర్టికులర్ లేఅవుట్ అనేది దే గివ్ టూ ఆర్ త్రీ ఆర్ ఫోర్ ఆప్షన్స్ దాంట్లో మీరు ఒకటి సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకోవాలి. సో ఒకటి సెలెక్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు నేనేం చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే యూ షుడ్ సెలెక్ట్ ఇట్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది పీపుల్ ఆక్యుపైయింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ ఏరియా. ఫర్ ఇన్స్టెన్స్ వన్ ప్లేస్ దట్ ఐ వెంట్ ఐ సా that these people had two male children, so two girls, so they selected a house, I'm not knowing they selected a house that was good for them. So there were, you know, I found that the two rooms were one a southeast room, the other one was a south room. As a rule, you can kindly make a note here, tomorrow even if anyone of you is planning to buy a home, you can kindly make a note, southeast. Do not vibe with young girls. So ఎందుకు ఏమైందంటే ఇప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు అడుగుతుంది నేను మీకు చెప్తాను. యాజ్ అ రూల్ సౌత్ అండ్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ విల్ నాట్ వైబ్ విత్ యంగ్ గర్ల్స్. ఇట్ యూ కుడ్ స్టార్ట్ సీయింగ్ ది ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఇట్ కుడ్ బి డిఫరెంట్లీ, దే కుడ్ బికమ్ అగ్రెసివ్. They can, instead of becoming assertive, they could become aggressive, or you know, they just go into the complex of inferiority. Lot of things can happen, so that is one thing. So you select chestunnappudu American homes anni vastu prakaram undina kai ledo cheppinappudu meer chusukala mee intlo evaru unnaru ani. Elders unnaru ankonde, elders unnappudu akkada you should have definitely one ishanya room there. Ishanya room ante north east north side. So meer select chestunnappudu that is how. సపోజ్ మీ ఆరోగ్యం సరిలేదు అంటే, మీ సీనియర్స్ ఆరోగ్యం సరిలేదు అంటే, సపోజ్ ఎవరు చెప్తే మీరు అగ్ని రోగం అనుకోండి, మళ్ళీ ఆరోగ్యం ఇంకా చెడుతూనే ఉంటుంది. సో ఆల్ దట్ యు నీడ్ టు డూ ఇస్ ఐ నాట్ ఆస్కింగ్ టు బ్రేక్ ఎనీథింగ్, ఆల్ దట్ యు నీడ్ టు డూ ఇస్ జస్ట్ షిఫ్ట్ దెమ్ టు ఈశాన్య ఆరోగ్యం. ఈశాన్య అంటే స్పేస్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రూల్డ్ బై జూపిటర్. జూపిటర్ ఇస్ ఫర్ హెల్త్ వెల్త్ అండ్ విజ్డమ్. సో విల్ గో ఫర్ ది నెక్స్ట్. Another definition of vastu is vasati iti vastu. Where you dwell is vastu. So whichever, it need not necessarily be your Indian home, it need not be your American home, or it need not be whatever. Everything where you, suppose you are there in a small quadrangle of four walls, that, you know, that is vastu. Akranante. So in fact, before coming here, I had planned, let me, you know, try to base all my audience on the basis of vastu. I think Vinayaka Yoko Chapitan, you know. I will try to do that, I'll group them on it. But if I choose that the placement is such a inside such a way, I can never group, you know, all of you as per vastu. Basically Nina Chapitan, right? So you go to the next one? Vastu can be explained in different ways. For instance, when you speak of vastu, it is to do with art. You look at the beautiful temples of India, you look at the beautiful palaces of India, the way they have the idols, the way they have the construction done, it is both art and engineering together. And the beauty is, you know, if you take a look at the beauty, you can feel that there are pieces of architecture. Even today, with all this, you know, with all the modern architect designed buildings, the temples and the palaces of India, even today they stand tall. Next. See, what we have Einstein saying, what is that? We owe a lot to the Indians.
Taught us how to count, without which no worthwhile scientific discovery would have been made.
He is Einstein telling us thus. We go on saying, many of us we go on saying, oh, vastu shastra, shastra ante em ayyo, nothing there. We have people like Einstein saying about Indian sciences as they have learned from there. One of these people, including Newton, what he said was, when his one of his pupils, you know, he saw that Newton had lot of astrological books in his library, and he said, "Sir, what is this, sir? You believe in astrology?" Then he said, "Young man, I have studied astrology. You have not." So people who go on speaking about saying astrology is not a science, Vastu is not a science, or something else is not a science, they have not read. So my father once said, suppose, you know, there is a person who has a PhD in slaughtering. He is an expert, so he can slaughter, you know, whatever, all the different meats and all that, you know, in different ways, at angles and pieces, or whatever it is. He goes on slaughtering. He has a PhD in that. If he goes and makes a remark on astrology, why should I answer? I don't need to defend astrology at all. Because he is a master in his subject, not in astrology. So like that, people are ignorant. When we have great people like Einstein saying that, Newton saying that, you know, there is wisdom in all sciences of India. So next, what is that? There, you know, you go back. There I said, you know, E is equal to MC square. Basically, when we speak of Vastu, we speak of energy, we speak of celestial energies, we speak of cosmic energies and such other things. We scientists, we so-called scientists who work within a framework of science, we feel that only we have energies like gravitational energies are there, magnetic energies are there, mechanical energies are there, solar energies are there, or some other energy. We were trying to limit only into that circle. But our ancients, they were very familiar with the metaphysical energies which we will, whatever do, we will never understand. Let me ask you a question. All of this scientific advancement now that we are, I'm not really putting down any of today's scientists, but I'm saying, all of the advancement of today's scientists in terms of all sorts of, you know, they're trying to make everything, are they able to produce the baby out of the mother's womb? How can any scientist of today is able to produce the baby out of mother's womb? Tell me. So, we go on saying, so science has its limits, today's science has its limits. So, when these limits are crossed by metaphysical scientists, we should not go on saying that it is superstition, it is superstition. It is not superstition because they have crossed much more than what we have. Show me the next one. See, before we go to the next, since I was speaking about the energies, I'll give you a simple references here. I want to make this, you know, not just a lecture, I want to make it an interactive session, and I would want people to ask me different questions with reference to whatever, you know, they have. For instance, most of you are aware, we'll tell, not the Vastu consultants, most of you who know a little of Vastu, you will tell, let's sleep to the south, let's sleep to the east, these directions you say. Do we also say sleep to the north? Let me find out.
No.
Why?
Magnetic.
So let me tell you. I just read out a small paragraph that I made now. It is normally recommended for people to sleep with their heads to the south. The human body is said to have the ability to acquire the property of magnetism because there is a large percentage of iron in the blood circulating all over our body. See, the entire earth is a big, huge magnet. We are constantly, you know, in interaction with that. And since what I just now said, there is content of iron in our body that gets magnetized. The south polarity is said to be induced in the feet and consequently north polarity in the head. South polarity in the legs, north polarity, we are constantly, you know, in touch with that. So south polarity is induced in the legs and north polarity in the head. This arrangement of poles in the human body is natural to it and therefore conducive to health when you put your head to the south and sleep. So similarly, when you put your head to the other side, you know, we have light poles repelling. When the light poles repel, naturally, you know, there is a difference in the blood circulation. There is a disturbance in the blood circulation. For some people, the BP may go up. For some people, the BP may come down. So that way, the health is affected. So north, placing the head to the north is absolutely bad. Similarly, see, this reference is one of these Markandeya Purana. I was just referring to some Purana. There they are not given any reasoning. But, you know, said Markandeya, he says, a person acquires strength and longevity by placing his head southwards and brings upon himself disease and death by lying down with his head placed to the north. So what it is, Puranam Daimo Chapinaro, but for them saying that something in the Purana, they definitely had the scientific basis. So today you are all speaking about flying to different places. I am flying to different places from different areas. Then, you know, during the Ramayana Mahabharata times, when, you know, they spoke of the Pushpaka Vimana, they were not aware of the scientific development that would take place many thousands of years ahead. So they were all men of great scientific eminence. We should not put down them. Then again, we have the electrical energy. Our ancients were aware of the usefulness of lightning rods. If you carefully look at temples, you know, the lightning rods are always put there. Every ancient temple top has iron or copper rods inserted into them. These rods placed at the top of the temple are similar to the lightning conductor rods that are now fixed to the rooftop of modern buildings. So a lot of things are there, you know, you just cannot dismiss that these people did not know anything about science. They did not consider any of these energy. They considered every sort of energy, but at the same time they also considered the metaphysical energy. Now let me tell you, how many of you are born in India? Everyone is born in India? How many of a good number of people are raising their hand? How many of you have houses that are 50 years and old, back at home? Only 1%, 2%, 3%, okay, not bad, improving. If you carefully observe, earlier times, about 100 years back, invariably, you had courtyard houses. Have you seen courtyard houses in India? India had central courtyard houses. So when you go to the modern person and ask him, you know, why were these done, he would reply, all the warm air will go up and the surrounding rooms would be cool. That is the reason that they had central courtyards. Can that be the reason for having the central courtyards? I am asking you. Now what is the reason? Now it could be for that, no? I mean that's also a fact, no? All the warm air when it goes up, the surrounding rooms have to be cool. So that could be a reason. That could be a reason known within the limited knowledge of us. But the metaphysical reason is, when you had courtyards, you had joint families. Harmony factor was taken care of by having the central courtyard open, the Brahmasthana. Today, most of the time, it is the jointless families that you have. So that's the difference. You take care of the Brahmasthana, the harmony of this particular fact, I have seen all over the world with reference to not just residences, I have seen with reference to businesses also. Wherever they have taken care of the central courtyard, not in terms of opening it to the sky. Today you can't open it to the sky because of various reasons. The weather could be a reason, security could be a reason, lot of reasons are there. But if you take care of the central area, it always means your business will do well, the harmony factor, you know, will be there among the working folk there. So here, we have importance to this sun. The directions, these are the importance, east and west directions are given. So the importance of sun is given. Basically, even in astrology, the importance of sun is given. The first importance, the morning rays are always healthy. That is the reason for Hindus, I tell, as soon as you get up, all of you, beginning from tomorrow, you start reciting Aditya Pradyam, looking into the east. Your arogya will definitely improve. Many of you may have different problems. It could be to do with migraine, it could be to do with diabetes, it could be to do with cysts in your ovaries. Lot of things are there, you know. But this is one very powerful mantra. Aditya Pradya is a mantra, is a particular brand of mantra which was given by sage Agastya to Lord Rama. Looking into the east, reciting this every day, it hardly takes about 3 to 4 minutes, will definitely give you better health. Your physical health will improve, your mental health also will improve. We go to the next. So magnetic energies, I have already talked to you about that. So we go to the next. See, this is also very important. Each one of us, we have an aura. Today, what's happening is you're finding lot of these row houses. So each house is connected to the other house. But in ancient India, they always distance. Like here also, you have lot of these houses. There always distance between the others. Ancient India, you know, they spoke of the huge spaces, and each house was distance from the other house. For the simple reason, even the home had its own aura or energy zone. So here, today's engineers tell us that when an earthquake takes place and the tremors run below the earth in the earthquake zone, if the buildings are spaced out, the destruction of the total properties that are there are minimal. They don't say there's no destruction because their distance, you know, by a certain area, when they fall, one could collapse, the tremor can stop at some area, another may not, you know, fall. For this reason, the ancients always spoke of the Padma Sahayaka Mandala, the 9x9 bit mandala, 9x9 module mandala, where the outer zone was always identified as Paishaja, the negative zone of energy. That is what they said. And for that reason, they always said you have to space out. Similarly, when it came to humans also, each one of us, we have an aura around us. For that reason, also, if you can see, I have not gone into any breaking of houses and all that until now. I am only telling you how to, this is all vastu, I am telling you how to take care of that. Ancient India, if you carefully observe, people, you know, had, traditionally they had their own seating arrangements. One, suppose, you know, there was a peetam. Peetam ante telustundi kada. Aa peetam ante nanagaru akkada dani meeda koochante emaina kani vere evarunna akkada koochuntaru ledu. Akkane ayana koochuntundi, aa peet tees pettukondi, tirigi ayana vachinaa phone cheyalante akkada pettukondi. So his energy was always conserved in that particular area. So this is what I said. For the same reason, in India, today say I'm introduced, for instance, Vijay introduces me to somebody else here. Immediately first thing is you come and shake your hand with me. There they never shook their hand. They only did their namaskara. For the simple reason, they did not want either of the energies to be disturbed. Each one of us, we will have our own evolution. So that evolution basis meeda maro name evolution undo danni disturb kavadi kammi unte maa dagane undi ఇంకొకరికి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ కాకూడదు అని దట్ వాస్ ది యాటిట్యూడ్. సిమిలర్లీ ఆయన దగ్గర జాస్తి ఉంటే అనవసరంగా మేము ఆయన కమిటీ చేసి తీసుకునేది వద్దు అని అని అనుకుంటా. ఫర్ దట్ రీజన్ దే ఆల్వేస్ నో డి నాట్ టచ్ హ్యాండ్స్ బట్ దే డిడ్ ది నమస్కారం. Now we come to the concept of Vastu Purusha Mandala. If you, this is a metaphysical concept where you know you the Vastu Purusha is made to sleep in that particular area. I am giving a small area where Vastu Purusha is, suppose you consider that as your side. Vastu Purusha is putting his head there. The head is always to the northeast. When we say the head is to the northeast, it means head is the thinking area, the brain is where you have. The thinking area is always Ishanya. So, consultants cheptuntaru, not time cheptuntaru, Ishanya gelich cheyadandi, Ishanya gelich cheyadandi cheptuntaru. So, Ishanya, when you take care of Ishanya, the thinking pattern is good, not only among you people, but your next generation and the next generation also. Every mandala, every room of yours, we will have the Ishanya. Northeast is not limited. Ante ikkada America lo em ayindi ante nenu observe chestunte ide cardinal directions orientation unde coming undi hech ga non cardinal directions orientation lo hech ga untadi. But there also you can identify that northeast area. So long as you take care of northeast area, generally the thinking pattern of all the family members will be good. And then again come down the central area, nabi ekrustendo apurushan nabi ekrustendo akane, that is where you know we have the brahmasthana, the dot is indicated. And the lower part, you know, which is there, that is the strength area. Strength area is southwest la vesinda. So southwest la vesinda nunchi most people go on saying, you know, southwest bedroom, southwest bedroom and, but common sense use cheyala. Today I'm saying terms, when I say today, it is today. In astrology, I relate astrology and Vastu. Astrology we call it as Vedanga, and Vastu we call it as Upaveda. So Veda, the source is Veda, we have to relate both. Ikkada em cheptunnanu ante south west strength area ni meeru illu chusi room south west lo bedroom undi nenu akkada kodukuntanu nenu akkada pothanu untanu ante at this point of time southwest lord Rahu is debilitated. Gocharamla neechasthanamla unnadu. Adiki meeru ippudu kochindi akkada naaku southwest room undi nenu occupy chestam master room southwest room teesukuntaa ante you will only suffer, you will not be happy. You can make out anyone if you are planning to buy a home with a southwest master room, don't do it. In Gochara, both Rahu and Ketu are in debilitation. And when this is the case, southwest rooms, master bedroom or tent, don't take them. On the other hand, you will take a master bedroom that is there in the northeast. Northeast to east to northwest to south, something is going to parvale. Primary interest will be of course good ventilation and all that. But master bedroom southwest town, this go. So then you find Rondo Chet Sita as a pretender, master portion. ఒకటి సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ లో పెట్టింది, ఒకటి నార్త్ వెస్ట్ లో పెట్టింది. సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ లో నార్త్ వెస్ట్ అంటే ఏమంటే దీస్ ఆర్ మూవింగ్ ఏరియాస్. ఇప్పుడు మీరు ఐఎమ్ ప్రాక్టికల్ టు యూజ్ హౌసెస్, మెకానికల్ గా నేను వాస్తవం ఏమో చెప్పకపోతలేదు. ఐఎమ్ ట్రైంగ్ టు సే దట్ యు నో వి మేక్ ఇట్ ప్రాక్టికల్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ది పీపుల్ సిట్టింగ్ హియర్. సో వాట్ ఐ వుడ్ సజెస్ట్ ఇస్ మీ రెస్పెక్టివ్ ఇండ్లకు మీరు ఆఫీస్ టైం పెట్టుకో, జస్ట్ చెక్ ఆన్ దట్. The ventilation aspect is northwest ante vayu, southeast ante agni. So agni ni constrict chese tappu, vayu ni constrict chese tappu. So it means ventilation is a very important aspect of a home. So what I'm trying to say here again, I'm repeating that again. If meeku ante New Jersey tara idi 18 inches snow avani ikkada Dallas lo raakunda pothe, every day, as soon as you get up, when the sun rises, you open all your windows, at least the bottom portion of all your windows. Ventilation is very important. Ventilation bagunte, southeast ante mogabedlu, northwest ante ammayilu. వాళ్ళందరూ తెలియకుండా ఆరోగ్యంగా పెరుగుతున్నారు. దేర్ థింకింగ్ విజ్ ది గుడ్. వాళ్ళ నుంచి పేరెంట్స్కు తొందర అయ్యింది. దిస్ ఐమ్ సేయింగ్ బికాస్ ఓవర్ పీరియడ్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ యూనో మెనీ ఇయర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఐ ఫౌండ్ దట్ ఈ వెనెవర్ ద వెంటిలేషన్ ఆస్పెక్ట్ ఇస్ బ్లాక్ ద ఫస్ట్ సఫరర్స్ విల్ బి ది యంగ్స్టర్స్ యంగర్ జనరేషన్. ఏసీలో ఉండేది బాగుంటుంది, అంత కంఫర్టబుల్గా కూల్గా ఉంటుంది. బట్ ఇట్ దర్ నో నీడ్ యూనో 3-4 hours ఓపెన్ చేసినా లేదు తప్పలేదు. మార్నింగ్ మీరు లేచిన తక్కువ ఏదో ఇక ఆల్వేస్ ఓపెన్ 3-4 hours ఓపెన్ చేయండి, మీకు మంచిది. అండ్ పర్టికులర్లీ ఇఫ్ పీపుల్ యూనో యంగ్స్టర్స్ బిలో 18-20 years, ఇట్ ఇస్ డెఫినెట్లీ గుడ్ దట్ ఎవ్రీ డే మార్నింగ్ యూ మేక్ ఇట్ అ హ్యాబిట్ టు ఓపెన్ ఆల్ ది విండోస్. నెక్స్ట్ చూడండి. ఐ విల్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు దిస్ వన్ బికాజ్ ఇక్కడ మీరంతా ఇచ్చేసినప్పుడు అమెరికన్ బిల్డర్స్ దే డోంట్ కన్సిడర్ దిస్ వన్. విల్ గో టు ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్. దే ఆల్వేస్ గేవ్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ టు ద ఓరియంటేషన్. నార్త్ ఈస్ట్ సౌత్ అండ్ వెస్ట్ ఓరియంటేషన్కి ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఇచ్చినారు. ఫర్ ది సింపుల్ రీజన్ దాట్ యునో మాన్సూన్ విండ్స్ నార్మల్గా దే కమ్ అట్ అన్ యాంగిల్ అండ్ నార్త్ వెస్ట్ ఓరియంటేషన్లో ఈ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ ఓరియంటేషన్లో వద్దు అని చెప్పి చేసినారు. అందుకు నేనేం చెప్పేది, వాట్ ఐమ్ ట్రై టు టెల్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఇస్ ఐ ఫైండ్ దట్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ బిగినింగ్ టు బై హౌసెస్ అండ్ ఆల్ దేస్ కమ్యూనిటీ ఏరియాస్. సో ఏరియాస్గా ప్లానింగ్ టు బై ఫర్ యూర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆర్ ఫర్ యూర్సెల్ఫ్ ఫర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ అస్ మచ్ అస్ పాసిబుల్ ట్రై ఫర్ అ ప్రాపర్లీ ఓరియంటెడ్ బిల్డింగ్. గెట్ దట్ బి యువర్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రయారిటీ. అండ్ లేనే లేదు అంటే అఫ్ కోర్స్ నథింగ్ కెన్ బి డన్, బట్ ఇన్ దట్ బిగ్ కమ్యూనిటీ యూ ఫైండ్ ప్రాపర్ ఓరియంటెడ్ బిల్డింగ్ ఐ వుడ్ సజెస్ట్ దట్ యూ వర్క్ ఫర్ దట్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్, దిస్ ఓరియంటేషన్ ఐ సెడ్ అ మార్జిన్ ఆఫ్ 12 degrees ఇస్ పర్మిటెడ్. Earlier time, the orientation was not based on compass. These mechanical devices ninchi cheskondedo, they were basing it on the movement of the sun. So telvari cycle of movement aina chusukuntundi, and dakshinayana uttrayana, that is you know solar ingress and northern ingress aina appudu naturally some kuncha change avutundi. So the 12 degrees when you put the compass, 12 degrees either to other point, you can comfortably, you know, say that it's oriented to the cardinal direction. Next. So this is angular orientation, and 45 degrees on tap, it you know, happens to be angular orientation. Angular orientation, if panne panala ante, there also I will not ask you to totally disband. You look into every other aspect, but if you are able to find a northeast oriented site, that definitely is good. Yes, next one. So people, when I go to for consultations, the northeast ఏది చెప్తే అప్పుడు మూల కలుచుకొని చూపిస్తారు సార్, దిస్ ఇస్ నార్త్ ఈస్ట్. Moola is not northeast, Moola is not southeast. This is based on the Peter Mandal. Every time you look into an area for buying or renting, taking on rent, you have to look, you divide that into three parts, either side, which happens to be the Peter Mandala. 9-module mandala is called the Peter Mandala. That cardinal directions importance to be Chinko, they identified that with the 4 Vedas, Rug Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. To identify the importance of the primary elements, they identified the northeast with water, southeast with fire, southwest with space, northwest with air, and then the central area with earth. Ikkadanu I find, you know, when I got for consultations to lot of people, lot of temples, including ISKCON and such people. If now one thing I noticed is, I also, you know, given consultations to a lot of corporate houses and all that. Somehow, you know, somebody has put some thought in these people's mind. Automatically, in a chapter, sir, southwest is earth, it is not space. Avad was saying that is another character. So a lot of people meet around the one of the Batak, the Vasta knowledge in the one of Mika Bhav knowledge. Southwest and Artho, it is not space any. All the original classical texts, including, I'll give the names, you can kindly refer to that. Maya Mata, Manasara, Samarangana Sutradhara, Manushalaya, Chandrika, or whatever. They very clearly say that the central part is Earth. For this reason, if you carefully observe in India, we always had the temple as the center of the place around which the city grew. In observe Chasinara, Srirangam Tithiskondi, Madurai Tithiskondi, the temple was always the center. Earth lana, that strength area lana, they always put the temple around which the city grew. So, each one is identified. These are all the Vastu identification. North is Ishanya, East is Aditya, that is Surya, and South East is Agni, then South is, what is that?
Yama.
Yeah, South is Yama. Yama, see here also repeated. South Yama, it does not mean destruction. Yama is not destruction. That is emancipation. Yama ante emancipation. So ipudu elderly people anta untaru anukondi. Elderly people anta vaallu dikku edhu chudochu ante yavase you look into the south, that's perfect. That is the direction of emancipation. You think better, you'll be able to advise your children better. Ipudu meer intlo anta peddavaallu anta unte mee chinnalaku adi advice cheyalante meeru you can comfortably look into the south, not the other way. You make the children look into the north, or make the children look into the east, and then give them the guidance. So south is Yama, and then southwest is Nairutya. See, Nairutya is again, Nairuti is demoness. But demoness me southwest teaching, how can you go on telling that southwest is the strength area where the master bedroom should be there? But the ancients have put, for whatever reason, they put the demon there. A demon jagala member question master bedroom cheskola. So this is also a concept, you be careful. Mechanical, you have a consultant who should check there. Oh, southwest master room, ledo, mekaya, ledo, don't go by that. Southwest need not be, and particularly now for the next 2 years, Rahu is in debilitation. So if you southwest to go there, we punch the ink, and we go bade, BP and level, akashan go there. And diabetes, initial diabetes will be one level. Third stage diabetes, same one thing. What do you call third stage or fourth stage diabetes? So, other than that, you will only face problems, your health will not improve, your headaches will improve. So those of you who are planning to buy houses with the southwest bedroom, you better drop that idea. Then west is Varuna. And then northwest is?
What about after 2 years?
What about after 2 years?
After 2 years, you get used to that, no?
And you said, can we buy it
somewhere? 2016, if the house comes, based on the fact that is Rahu's area, I normally do not recommend. That is good for elderly people, not for people like you. You are all IT guys, huh? You all work in IT. Not for you. Suppose, but me will lay on time, don't worry. Master bedroom, not get changed. So bedroom. Your parents can live. Definitely not for the younger folk. Definitely would not advise. Then, okay, so we go to the next one. Then all these primary elements are identified for the different direction. And like I've earlier said, the Vedas are the four cardinal directions. And water is northeast. Fire is Agni, the southeast is fire, southwest is space, and northwest is air. The next one. Next one.
So, what is the best place to sleep in your bedroom? You said like southwest is not good.
Coming from, apart from this one, I tell you, generally for couples, for elderly couples, southwest is okay. Because they pass through all the grinding mill, So at that point of time, the Rahu's disturbance will not be much. But at this point of time, even for them, pushing them into the southwest is bad. But for the younger couples who are still in the process of taking the responsibilities, you're taking care of the children and all that, I would give two options. One is south, the other one is west. West, they said Paschima, Purki, Vardana. So west is the perfect, nothing to worry. South is also good. South is the Dakshina, Dakshina Murti is the south. So you can be in the south. South and west are good. Now connect to this place. Each area also, you know, we have identified with the planet and the color there. Northeast will be Jupiter. Jupiter's color is gold. So suppose in your horoscope, Jupiter is in Uchastana. Are you listening?
Yes.
Or are you talking between yourselves? Suppose, you know, in your horoscope, Jupiter is in Uchastana. I would say that I'm not asking to buy gold for your wife or gold for your husband. What I'm saying is, make use of that option of gold by having a beautiful sunrise painting there. In the Ishanya of your living room, have a beautiful painting of the sunrise, where you know your gold is seen. So that Jupiter strike is now taken care of. Jupiter is Dhanakaraka, Putrakaraka, and Nanakaraka. So the wisdom, wealth, and the, not that, you know, it is, you have to put your effort. Don't say just by putting the photograph, from tomorrow I'll be wealthy and tomorrow I'll have all the wisdom. Nothing will happen like that. You have to put your effort, but that will supplement your efforts. Then east is the copper red. Suryadu, Evaraku Suryadu. Any of you know the, your horoscope? Sun no Aries to ever kunnara? Ni kunnara?
Sorry, what is the question?
Sun. Uh-huh. In whose horoscope is it in Aries? I'm speaking of the Hindu horoscope, not the Western horoscope. Western horoscope, what is, they do not deduct the Ayanamsha. So Ayanamsha deduction I made to Suryadu akkadunte, appudu this particular color is definitely good. The color can be used in different ways. For instance, in your home, you know, you have interior, indoor plants. So for instance, the kind of flowers you can see in the mirror. And the petrol in the nature that also, you know, will give some comfort in terms of that particular house. Venus is that is southeast. Then we come to south. The Mars, which is the bright red. Then we come to southwest. Southwest, like I said, it is going to be Rahu, and the color given there is indigo. Then we go, we come to the west. West is Saturn. Mero, one of you asked me, no, just now, which would be good for India, eh? See, west, ne chepte, west, పడమర పడమరకు పశ్చిమ పుష్టి వర్ధనం చెప్తున్నారు. సో అది మంచిది. ఇప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది అంటే వెస్ట్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో రూల్డ్ బై సాటర్న్. మీకు మీ హారోస్కోప్ లో సాటర్న్ డెబ్యూటేషన్ లో ఉంటే అప్పుడు దట్ విల్ నాట్ బి ద స్ట్రెంగ్త్. ఇట్ ఇస్ బెటర్ యూ గో టు ది సౌత్. బట్ సపోజ్ మీ హారోస్కోప్ లో సాటర్న్ ఇస్ ఎగ్జాల్టెడ్ దెన్ యూ నో దట్ డెఫినెట్లీ విల్ గివ్ యూ లాట్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ అండ్ మీరేం వర్క్ చేస్తారో యూ హ్యావ్ సమ్ సక్సెస్ ఇన్ దాట్. So we then go to the northwest. Northwest is ruled by moon. Moon is Manakaraka, Matrukaraka, and the color for moon is white. Then we come to the next one, which is north. North is Mercury. We did not just play. Tomorrow or when you ask me questions, all that will help you. Mercury is Buddhi Karaka, the intellect. Mercury is for intellect. He is also the Janakaraka. He is also for finances. And his color is green. So these are the colors. Then as far as the central area is called, that is Prithvi. So suppose the living area, the living area, the center of the living area, Okay, what they can do is they can try to have, you know, some nice green color indoor plants, put on a small pedestal. That is all. Simple things like that. It will also make your home aesthetic, nice looking. At the same time, it also takes care of the vast aspect. So next one. See, this is one important thing. In India, when we construct houses, you know, I tell them, this is how you have to go. Here in America, automatically all this is taken care of, because when they give the land, you know, we have a lot of space behind, front and end. But generally, you maintain the area, you know, the outside need, absolutely, you know, construction should be there, because that's the paisa charno. The second and the third, you know, they are habitable zones, Manushya and Daiva. Third is the change of Brahma, but Nabi, you should see that, the importance of Nabi, మీరు ఇల్లు పని టైంలో చెక్ చేయండి, స్ట్రక్చరల్ ఆస్పెక్ట్ నుంచి ఆ సెంటర్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ పిల్లర్ గిల్లర్ వచ్చింటే అప్పుడు మీరు డూ లిటిల్ బ్రీత్ థింకింగ్ అండ్ గో ఫర్ అనదర్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్. వినయ్, యూ సీ దిస్ వన్? ఓకే, నౌ ఐ స్టాప్ టాకింగ్ ఫర్ సమ్ టైమ్. Why did they get up? You know, what did we do with regard to the Shirdi Sai? You were there for the meeting. Tell me, let's make you speak. Come here. You give an introduction of yourself as well.
I don't want
to introduce myself, but I'm just like. No, what? Sai Temple, you know,
just want to let you know how.
బాబు గారు వచ్చినప్పుడు హీ లుక్డ్ అట్ ద హోల్ ల్యాండ్ అండ్ థాట్ దట్ ఇట్ వాస్ ఆల్సో బ్రోకెన్ డౌన్ ఇంటు 9 సెక్టర్స్. దెన్ వీ హ్యాడ్ ఎ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ డిప్ ఆన్ ద నార్త్ ఈస్ట్ సైడ్ అండ్ ఇట్ వాస్ ఎన్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ ఆన్ ద సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ ఆల్సో. సో టు మిటిగేట్ దట్ స్టిల్ ద సెగ్మెంట్స్ వర్ మేడ్ ఇంటు 9. Then the Brahmana Abhi, what the center point of that was set.
We'll take a look at this.
Yeah. And the actual temple, the main mandir of Baba was also shifted a little bit towards the southwest corner, but where the, as the, here it says Graha Nabi, but for our it's
Devalaya
Nabi. So that's the main focus on this one.
For that, you know, I gave importance. Everything was perfect. But when I came to my hotel, that was not taken care of, I said that, and the architect, you know, he definitely took care of that. Now, you know, that is thing. As a rule, if you are planning to, you know, build homes back in India, what I suggest is, this is a very important rule of vastu. Suppose it goes in the straight line, no material benefits will be there for you. Suppose the Brahmanabhi and the Gruhanabhi. Brahmanabhi is the sighting center, Gruhanabhi is the structure center. If they are to the northeast or southeast or northwest of each other, there will be eternally problems among the family. Harmony will go for a toss. You can have Vastu Prakaranga, bedroom southwest. కిచెన్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ ఇంకోటి దీని అంత చెప్పిన సంతోషంగా మీరు చేసి ఉంటారు. బట్ ఇఫ్ ది స్ట్రక్చర్ ఈజ్ టు ది నార్త్ వెస్ట్ ఆర్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద నాబీ, యువర్ హార్మనీ విల్ గో ఫర్ ఎ టాస్. సో మీరు ఇంట్లో అక్కడ బ్యాక్ హోమ్ మీరు కాదు, లేదంటే మీ జనాలు మీ రిలేటివ్స్, మీ పేరెంట్స్, మీ బ్రదర్స్ ఏమైనా ప్లాన్ చేస్తుంటే వాళ్ళకి చెప్పండి, ఫస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ అని కైండ్లీ మేక్ అన్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్. సో నెక్స్ట్ వన్. See, once you have purchased the home, say here you have purchased the home, how you have to live, that's also very important. Here you have made a lot of traffic, there you have to go to southwest Romo, south Romo, northwest Romo, to choose in Kena. Here you have how you live in there, and that's what you need to do. One general guidance I'll give you, if you carefully look at this diagram, we came Governor Astendakra.
Shapes are
there. Because Mir Potan is going to the town. కదా మెట్లు ఉంటుందా? స్టెప్స్ ఉంటుందమ్మా, స్టెప్స్ ఎక్కువ ఫస్ట్ ఫ్లోర్. ఏ డైరెక్షన్లో ఉన్నది? వాట్ ఈస్ ది టైప్ ఆఫ్ మూమెంట్? No, forget about west, north, east and all that.
Clockwise.
So that is also very important. So when you buy home, the first thing, especially I'm speaking, you know, especially when it's regard to a family, whether it's regard to a company where you have a lot of people and all that, the first importance that I would give is look into the movement of the stairs into the first floor. Pradakshana kavala, that's the importance of that. Aruhya pradakshanam cheppinaru. That was as you go up, you have to turn clockwise. And the guidance part ko, miro, you are the government discipline. The potential purchase chese vantlo, adi okati government discipline. Then the next one. Yeah, office law, again, there also, you know, you have to take care. Bosses second poochala, managers second poochala, accounts on second poochala, such things are also very important. You know, you can have, it can be a bit big whole area like this, where you get the partitions done. Just number, you have to take into consideration. Primarily, when it comes to, you know, anything to do with accounts, manager who is, you know, looking into the accounts, so, or the boss, so, Estavana, Chonte, I will not make him mechanically go sit in the southwest. I will say, go to Jupiter's area, which is northeast, or go to Mercury area, intellect area, which is north, or go to the Arogya area, which is east. North, east and northeast are always very good for anything to do with accounts. This same thing can also apply to your home. If you are a husband and wife, if you are fighting every day, then over accounts, then you go into the northeast sector and then try to discuss properly. Hopefully, you know, Jupiter, will, being a benefit planet, will ease out the wrinkles, you know, between both of them. So next year. See, this is also very important. I think I told you about that. As a rule, never sleep to the north and the west. I noticed here, but Sumar Janadagan and Pineapple consultation of the Pineapple, I noticed lot of people, at least a few people, I won't say lot of people, a few people, without knowing, you know, they have been putting their heads to the north. And you know, they are going through a lot of misery, which came to my knowledge only after I talked to them. I just told them, you know, you reorient yourself to the south. Or if you are one thing, let me tell you, if the younger generation is there who are in the process of study and all that, I would ask them to orient themselves for sleeping to the east, not to the south. So younger generation, one తూర్పుకు తల పెట్టుకోమని చెప్పండి. చెప్పండి.
మార్నింగ్ లేచి ఈస్ట్కి వెళ్ళి చూడాలంటుంది
కదా. ఈస్ట్ చూడమని ఎవరు చెప్పినారు? మీ పెద్దవాళ్ళు చెప్పినారు, శాస్త్రం చెప్పలేదు. యూ లుక్ ఇన్ టు ద రైట్ డైరెక్షన్. సపోజ్ యూ పుట్ యువర్ హెడ్ టు ది ఈస్ట్. ది యంగ్ బాయ్ పుట్స్ యంగ్ బాయ్ అండ్ యంగ్ గర్ల్ హీ ఆర్ షీ పుట్స్ ది హెడ్ టు ది ఈస్ట్. రైట్ టర్న్ తీసుకోమని చెప్పినారు. రైట్ టర్న్ చేసుకుంటే ఏ దిక్కు చూస్తారో? ఈస్ట్ తలకాయ పెడితే రైట్ టర్న్ చేసుకుంటే వాళ్ళు వీటిలో ఏ దిక్కు చూస్తారో? నార్త్. నార్త్ ఇస్ రూల్డ్ బై మర్క్యూరీ ఇంటెలెక్ట్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ద చిల్డ్రన్. దే లుక్ ఇన్ టు ది ఇంటెలెక్ట్ డైరెక్షన్ అండ్ దెన్ గెట్ అప్. సో ఈస్ట్ చూడాలని ఎక్కడా చెప్పలేదు. అండ్ సపోజ్ వీటే ఫర్ ఎల్డర్స్ అని నేను చెప్తాను. ఫర్ ఎల్డర్స్ ఆరోగ్యంతో ఇంపార్టెంట్ అవుతుంది. సపోజ్ మీ ఆరోగ్యంలో చేరుకోలేదు ఆర్ ఎల్డర్స్ మెంబర్స్ హూ హావ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీస్ ఐ టెల్ దెమ్ టు పుట్ దేర్ హెడ్స్ టు ది సౌత్. బట్ ఐ ఆస్క్ దెమ్ టు టర్న్ టు ది రైట్. వాటిలో సౌత్ నుంచి రైట్ అక్ టర్న్ చేస్తే, తలకాయ సౌత్ అక్ పెట్టి రైట్ అక్ టర్న్ చేస్తే ఏది చూస్తారమ్మా? ఈస్ట్. కరెక్టా? సో ఎల్డర్ జవాబ్దారీ ఉండే వాళ్ళు ఈస్ట్ చూస్తారు. So that way you have to do it. So one thing is, invariably, you know, disease that time need not be the physical disease. You know, generally, depression got to happen. So this direction is very important. Naatak pettala, naatak petta paltala. I find there are a lot of people who start visiting psychiatrists and psychiatrists. Next. So whatever I just now said, no? You can see that, no? That is, you know, if you put your heads to the south or east, seniors, Gujar, and the ex-Mahasmati. Go back. And the extras go, same thinking, that's what I said. So they look into the intellect and get up, no? So the same thinking as the chance. So next problem. విట్లు బాగా చదవలే విట్లు బాగా చదవలే అని చెప్పి ఇచ్చేస్తుంటారు. అందుకు రీజన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఎక్కడెక్కడ పసిపెట్టి చదివిస్తుంటే వాళ్ళు ఖండితంగా చదవలేదు. అందుకు అసలు నేనేం చెప్పేదంటే యంగ్స్టర్స్ని 5 బంచెస్ 10 బంచెస్ సెక్టర్స్ అంటే ఇప్పుడు మీకు అర్థం అయిందా? నేను ఆ పీఠ మండలా 3x3 చూపిస్తూ చూడండి. సో దాంట్లో మీకు నార్త్ ఈస్ట్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ అంటే తెలుస్తుంది. సో మీ ఇంట్లోన సౌత్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ అండ్ ఈస్ట్ సెక్టర్స్లోన అబ్బాయిలు చాలా బాగా చదువుతారు. దేర్ ఇంటెలెక్ట్ దేర్ థింకింగ్ వర్క్ ప్రాపర్లీ. అదే అమ్మాయిలు నార్త్ నార్త్ వెస్ట్ వెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది హ్యాబిటేషన్. సపోజ్ యూ నో హ్యాబిటేషన్ ఇన్నర్ మీన్ ద ఎంటైర్ థింగ్. ఇట్ కెన్ బి యువర్ రూమ్. సపోజ్ మీకు మీ రూమ్లో మీరు తల్లి అయిన వాటి బిడ్డలు చదివిస్తారనుకోండి. చదివించినప్పుడు ఎక్కడో ఒక ట్రీట్మెంట్ చదివించే బదులు యూ మేక్ దెమ్ స్టడీ. ఏమైనా ఉంది అమ్మా?
మీరు
తెలుగు మాట్లాడారు కదా? మై గాడ్, యు నాట్ ఎ తెలుగు లేడీ. అండ్ వాట్ ఐ సెడ్ వాస్ మేడం, అప్రాపర్ మిమ్మల్ని చూస్తే డౌట్ వస్తుంది. మేడం, వాట్ ఐ సెడ్ వాస్ బాయ్స్, యంగ్ బాయ్స్ దే స్టడీ బెటర్ ఇన్ ది సౌత్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ or east sectors of the home or of the office or of the room. Office lo chinna file undaledo, so forget about that. Ipro in terms of home, you know, young boys, they definitely study better in south, southeast or east of the home or those areas of the room. Whatever room you select, try to make them sit there, they definitely will study better. As far as the girls are concerned, I would say, you know, north, northwest and west. Yeah, the next one. See, any of you who are planning educational institution, few people here, you know, they may already be running tutorial schools and such other thing. For them, what I would say is, where you have the play area for the kids is also very important. Normally for the kids, the play areas recommended are north, which is to do with Mercury, east, which is to do with sun, and northeast, which is to do with Jupiter. So in an area, you know, you again, they are divided into 9 parts. You identify those parts. Those parts, you can, you know, try to make them the play areas for the children. Yeah, the next one. This is, you know, understanding the compatible directions astrologically. Do we take a small break now, Sirisha?
Yeah.
Oh, where is Sirisha? Sirisha is missing.
Task for facing rooms, you know all these things, right? In India, most of we look for east or north direction because we enter into home, into house from east or north direction. But here, most of the times, our hereditary garages. This question comes up from many players a lot of times. So should they look for east? If they are entering from 80-90% of the times we enter to garage. That's hereditary. If we buy an east facing home, we enter from west facing. So what would you suggest? That is one thing. And here we cannot match 100% match, also even not 50%. Are there any 4 or 5 things, major things, that bias can look into that and select, okay, this is good for, this satisfies most of the vast criteria, so that I can buy this fish. Are there any 4 or 5 major things?
Before, what's your name?
Praveen Billa.
Okay, before I answer Praveen, I would like to, you know, speak a little about this. The first thing is, the ancient scholars, they have not promulgated any direction. So if today's consultants are saying north and east, north and east, they are very ignorant. They only highlighted the importance of good ventilation, so any direction was approved. But astrologically, suppose you go through books like Bruhat Jataka or Bruhat Parashara or some other standard textbook, they identify certain compatible directions to certain astrological signs. Now I think you pull the other up it again. When I say astrological sign, you also should know, it's not the sun sign that you look in predictions in the newspapers. The moon sign is what is important. When you speak of the moon sign, that is what is called the Janma Rashi. Now, with respect to this, you can make a note of this. People who are born in Vrishabha, which is Taurus, south and west are approved. I will go into that, your query, I will go into a little later. I will first explain this one. South and west. So that means the ancients have not prohibited south, they have not prohibited west. What they said was certain directions are compatible, you can comfortably go. When I was telling about this one in one of my lectures, a few people sitting like you, they asked me, "Sir, I am Taurus, but my wife is Simha. What do we do?" Then another, the second person said, "Sir, my parents are Taurus and Simha, Leo. But I am Vrishika and my sister is something else." So I said, you map everything, you look into the common, which is the common planet. Suppose out of four, you have three having west direction compatible, you go for that. So this is also an important point. But more important is, when you go from the west, it does not mean that you should not go from the east. For instance, normally that answers the question. So you buy a west-oriented thing, where you have the Mahabharata there, you never use it. So you go into the back and then come from that to the east, so you don't need to bother about that. You understand? Because there will always be one person in your family who is compatible to that direction. So here, this is how you have to take it. So based on this one, you know, Gemini and Cancer, but Gemini is, Mithuna and Gemini, south and west. Where I put, you know, the letter in the yellow color, it only means that is a very important direction. And it does not mean that you have to always go for that. The ventilation aspect is what is seen. Earlier homes was not like our home. Today, you know, you buy an apartment, you say it's an east apartment, I'm going there. The east door is always locked. So there is no ventilation. What is the purpose of having an east door there? It doesn't make any sense. So where the ancients, what they said was, the ventilation should always be there, compulsory gear in those directions. When they came to the astrological aspects, that is it. So now you know the purpose, suppose you know you buy a south facing, south orientation. On the south, somebody says in the south you should not open its Yama's direction. You keep it closed, you will be the loser, not the person who has given the consultation. So similarly, for Kataka, you have south and west. West is important for them. For Leo, Simha, north and west. North is important. Can you see? So here, if you carefully observe, Simha, Kanya and Tula, all the three directions are compatible. There for some, north is more compatible. For there for some, west is more compatible. You go to the next. Similarly for that, these are all again based on the moon sign. Hilly Rodhaga Nevo, Rushika Scorpio North and East, Dhanur or Sagittarius North and East, Makara and Capricorn North. So again, North and East are common for these three signs, but for some North are more important, for some East are more important. Similarly for Kumbha, Meena and Mesha, that is Aquarius, Pisces and Aries, South and East they become common. For Kumbha, South becomes important. So when you are again carefully check on this, say South, Kumbha is South is important. You go back. For Rishabha also South is important. So that way, even when you make your friendships, you just check up. Normally, Kumbha and Rishabha are always good friends. You check, and I don't know, you just check from today onwards, you look into that aspect also. So the compatibility is always there. So you can go to the next. Yes. Okay. Generally, you wanted a few general principles. So few general principles, I will not say anything right now. You can just take a look at this one. In a place, every place we will have northwest, northeast, everything is there, no? Generally, this is how it is. North is the place for treasury. If you want your money to multiply, keep your treasury in the north. Mechanically, don't go again to the southwest. People say southwest to Tuku Undola, Paru Undola, Aka Petandi, Aka Petter Melase, every nation Lane Mundi. Then you go to the northeast. Northeast is free space where your knowledge and such things should be. So relax down there. So education and library is the only bed for that. Then east, Lana. You have the morning sunrays coming in, you can have the general living area. East and northeast as general living area are definitely good. Then southeast from Chapnasta, you normally tend to have the kitchen, it will be there only. If it's not there also, don't bother. Wherever the kitchen is, you see that the cooking is done on the east platform, simple. ఎక్కడ నార్త్ వెస్ట్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ అక్కడ ఎక్కడ ఉంటుంది అని అనుకోండి, మీరు ఇచ్చేసినప్పుడు మీ కిచెన్లో మెయిన్ కుకింగ్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ ఈస్ట్లో ఉంటే దట్ ఈస్ గుడ్ ఇన్ యు డోంట్ నీడ్ టు బాదర్. ఫర్ ఇన్స్టెన్స్ కేరళలో మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది కిచెన్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద నార్త్ ఈస్ట్. సో సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ అని అనుకోండి అది తప్పవుతుంది. ఇప్పుడు ఏమంటే కుకింగ్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ ఈస్ట్లో ఉండాలి. దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ సౌత్. South is, you know, this for the sun, I just now told you, the bedroom in the south is very good. Then, what else? Southwest, for the elderly people, that is good. Southwest is good, but at this point of time, I told you for another 2 years, and don't go for a southwest bedroom. Then, west, in Chapti, Pushti Vardhanam in Chapti, so that is the strength area. Suppose you want in your office you have some space there, you can in your home you have some space, you can have the gym there. Then in the northwest, granary, toilets, animal sheds, the garage, guest rooms. Toilets go, guest go, get that pretty much in it. So that's it. You go to the next. So that's it. I still have a lot more, you know, that's all for a detailed seminar I will do it. But generally I want you to say something. If you have any queries, be free to ask me. I will give you whatever guidance I can.
It was a very valuable seminar, and please give a big round of applause. Make some changes and make sure we are all in harmony and with good energy. So I think every suggestion you have given benefits somebody or the other in this room. I think that's the biggest point for this seminar. And if anybody, like Papa Garu said, if anybody wants to schedule any appointments or anything, he's here till Tuesday. So you can collect Vijay's number or my number, and you can call one of us and we can help you with that. We wouldn't have been able to bring this program for you without our sponsors. We thank all our sponsors, Babaji over here, for letting us use this facility, and working with us with all the arrangements and everything. We thank Babaji. And I request actually Bindu Gari from Babaji to give the flower bouquet for Umar, to Uma Rani Gari. She's Niranjan Babugar's wife. She's also here with us. So. Patiently travels with him everywhere and gives him all the energy. We thank Internet Medicine Urgent Care, Ram Konara Garu, Oris Manapadi, Desi Plaza, South Fort Dental, Patel Law and Trends. And I want to we want to thank all the volunteers who helped us bring this, and South Fort Dental also. Also, I want to tell you, remind you again that we have the upcoming programs Balala Samaralu on 24th November, and it's we hope all of you can participate with your kids and make sure that also is a successful event. Thank you so much.